Okay, however, we are learning the Sefer B'tuchachotam, and it is Parshas Vayetze, two Verlach this week, one on Torah, one on Tefillah. We'll start with Tefillah. Vayikra Hashem Hamokem Ahu Beis El, and Yaakov calls this place the house of Hashem, Beis El. V'ulam Luz Shem Ha'il Rishena. But you should know the Torah tells us that the name of the city previously was Luz. Okay. So Rabbi Yaakov tells us that in this pasuk we actually have a reference to both to davening, to tefillah, to shachris and to ma'ariv, and we see in the pasuk there's an idea that shachris, the tefillahs we say by shachris are more quickly accepted because shachris is a time of chesed as opposed to ma'ariv, which is a time of din. So it says Rabbi Yaakov, we see this in the pasuk. First of all, Hashem Baiker Tishma Kaili. In the morning, when things are clear, HaKadosh Baruch Hu hears your voice. That's number one. Hashem Baiker Tishma Kaili. So there is an inyan in Shachris. We maybe run through Shachris, but we see we spend a lot more time in our Shachris prayer, in davening Shachris, because Hashem Baiker, in the morning, Tishma Kaili, you hear my voice. Chesed Kel. The Shem Kel goes along with HaKadosh Baruch Hu's Chesed, which is also Kal Hayayim, by day. So Shachris is connected to the name of Hashem of Kel, because it's Shachris, the time of Chesed. And Chesed, the name of Hashem of Kel, is Chesed. So Shachris is a time where our tefillahs are more readily accepted. It says Rabbi Yaakov, Vayikra Hashem HaMakom HaHu, he called the name of the place Beis Kel. Kel being chesed, this is referring to Shachris. So Shachris is a time of Kel. It's a time where HaKadosh Baruch Hu accepts our tefillahs. Ulam. But no, that Luz Shem Ha'il Rishayna. Rishayna, meaning what happens before Shachris. The day begins with Arvis. The beginning of the day, the first tefillah was Arvis. That's the first tefillah. It was called Luz. Luz is a remez to din. Ma'ariv, the tefillah Rishayna, is Luz. Vispala Luza is Lamed Vav Zayin Hey, which are the Seifei Tevis of Duna, which is the same gematria of the Shem Adnas, which equals din. Okay, the Shem of Adlav Dal Nun Yud is a Shem that corresponds to din. It's talking about Ma'ariv. So even though it's Larishayna, the tefillah that we said originally was Luza has to do with din. But the Shem of Adlav Dal Nun Yud is also the letters of Dina, like Dina de Machus of Dina. It's an inin of din. And therefore, it's the morning tefillah, which is more readily acceptable. It's full of chesed, as opposed to the night tefillah, which is full of din. Now, if you notice, there's a reference here to a makam and an ear. Makam and ear refer to batim knesias and batim midrashas. And there's a special inin of davening in a shul or in a base medrash. Because the place, it's dafka places that are called something. And Rabbi Yaakov brings the Gemara of Miyem Shecha Beis Milish Ein LaKadosh Baruch Hu Ba'alame Ela Arba Amish Al Halacha B'Vad. So this is besides Shachris being more readily accepted tefillah because of the chesed that's associated with it. You also want to make sure you're in a makam, you're in an ear, you're in a Beis HaKnesses or Beis HaMidrash to have our tefillahs more readily acceptable. HaKadosh Baruch Hu should answer all of our tefillahs. That's something on tefillah. Now let's talk about Torah. An awesome remez in the parsha. Vayarvine, so Yaakov goes over to the wells, he gets the charan, and he sees a be'er basadeh, a well in the field. Vine sham shloisha edrei tzayin roiv tzimaleh. There are three groups of flocks of sheep. Ki min ha-be'er ahu yashka ha-darim. It was because from that well they would give to their flocks to drink. V'evin ha-gadoy la-pi ha-be'er, but there's this great big stone on top of the well. V'nez v'sham ha-kol ha-darim. And all the flocks would gather there. V'goluas ha-evin ha-pi ha-be'er. They'd roll over the stone. V'yishka ha-satzein. And they'd give their sheep to drink. V'yishivas ha-evin ha-pi ha-be'er. And then they would return the stone to its place. V'yemer lam Yaakov. Yaakov says to them, Achai, my brothers, me'ayin atem. From where are you? V'yemeru me'charan. They said, we are from Charan. Okay. Yaakov says, from here, it goes like this. You know, the Beis HaMikdash was a place where we were able to be shayiv, where we drew Ruach HaKodesh. And there was not just Ruach HaKodesh, but wisdom came forth from the Beis HaMikdash. Unfortunately, when the Beis HaMikdash was destroyed, the Sitra Achra grew more powerful and was able to cover up the Mayanis, the wellsprings of Chachma. And it took us a long time. The Chacham had to be Isaac and delve into Torah to really be able to have the power to get that the Chachma back. But the Sitra Achra had the power to cover it up again. And this was an issue that we still have to deal with. Rabbi Yaakov says this is something that Yaakov Avinu was seeing in Ruach HaKodesh. Listen to this. So he sees a be'er, he sees the be'er maim chaim, he sees the Torah. Alternatively, the Shechina is basada, it's in galus, it's scattered throughout the whole world. And there are yidin that are coming, gathering there. They want to be able to drink from as well. The shleish edrei tzayin could be kahan, levim, yisraelim, all parts of Kal Yisrael, wanting to get from the Shechina, wanting to get the Torah. It could be a reference to the Torah, the Tainavim and Ksuvim, or Tanakh, Mishnah, and Gemara. Shleisha Edritzain, Reitzim Aleh. And why are they there? Kimina Be'er, Hahi, Yashku Adam. Because it's through this Be'er that Yashku, the Tamid Racham, will be able to quench the thirst of all of Klal Yisrael that are looking for Chachma. Chachma Sater, to be able to connect to the Shechina. Vaven Gadayla Pia Be'er. But there's this huge rock on top of the wellsprings, on top of the Be'er, on top of the Torah, our ability to connect to the Shechina. The Evan HaGadol is the Sitra Achra. And we can't get to it. So what do we have to do? V'nes v'shama kol adar. All the Talmid HaChacham have to gather there. And they have to toil in learning in Torah. And v'nes v'shama, when everybody comes together, we're able to get the Shechina. The goal was even me apia be'er, and through their learning Torah, and through their achdus, were able to take away the even, the hishkatz atzayin, and to give everybody to drink water. The flock, everybody's able to learn Torah to connect to the Shechina again. Veishivas even apia be'er l'mukayba, but the Sitra Achra has the ability to return the even onto the be'er, and therefore we feel like we're back in the darkness. Yaakov says to them, he's asking the Chacham, what are you doing? Are you doing enough to be able to uncover the depths of the halacha? Are you exerting yourself enough? And they tell him, we are from Charon. Charon is the oisias of mechuvarim. We're whitening. We are toiling so hard to get this back, to get the Shechina back. I was Arkan Divrei Maron, Rabbeinu Yaakov. I was just wondering if we could read it a little bit differently. We could say maybe Yaakov is telling them, Achai, me'ayin atem. You know, there's this place, the world is created, yesh me'ayin. Very high level is where we don't know anything. It's ayin, it's like nothing to us. But that's a place of great kedusha. And maybe Yaakov is telling them, when you feel like the Sitra Achra is putting the stone above the well, and you can't connect to the Torah, and you can't connect to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, you can't connect to the Shechina, and you feel like what power do I have? But Yaakov tells them, Achai, my brothers, may Ayin atem, you are from Ayin. You're from that great place. You have a neshama Torah from that great place, and tap into that, and you will be able to uncover the depths of the Torah.